Hello everyone. Now we're going to hike Lumber Ridge Trail back to Tremont. Took a pretty good break there. No one ever came by either. A lot of sitting there. Looks like we may have a little bit more color up through here than we did on the off trail. I'll definitely get back way before dark. I just didn't know how bad that off trail was gonna be. Thank you. to stop here in a second and take my jacket off again. I was sitting taking a break. I started getting a little chilly. Now that I'm moving again, I'm getting warm. Thank you. That's a little mole. Moved too fast to get it with the camera though. The off trail was not as bad as I was afraid it was going to be. definitely getting chillier. It's a cold wind blowing. I'm actually surprised. I figured I'd be passing people on this trail. I can't understand why people would want to do the trail the opposite direction though, if you're going to do the off trail. Walking through the creek, you'd want to save the crossing's basically to last. That is if you don't like hiking in wet feet. Doesn't really bother me any. Me, I'd rather get the water crossings done first. That way you don't have to worry about a rain shower hitting. Plus, like I said, I find it easier to climb the steep hills instead of going down the steep hills. First Lumber Ridge really doesn't matter. You're gonna have uphill both ways on it. Now you gotta climb to the top of the ridge, then go down, and then just you're gonna turn around and go do it again. You have to go do it again. Up and then back down. It's not that bad. I'll reach a point on this trail where the switch works mainly downhill. And that's basically after we cross to the other side. I'm not sure yet, but I'm considering going back to Mount Cameron because I really liked it up there. There's something I wanted to do, but I can't do it now since they got Big Creek Trail closed. I know the campsite there's still open, so I may hike down it yet. As far as Big Creek Trail, it's closed because of damage. I was hoping to hike from the Cosby side all the way to the maybe the Midnight Hole, but like I said, Big Creek Trail's closed now. Apparently, part of the trail's gone, and the bridge at the campsite's gone. And that was a huge bridge, not just a log bridge, it was a big bridge. I have a video of it in my library somewhere. So I figured I might hike down to the campsite at least where the bridge washed out. And possibly when I get back up to the AT, head off to the Mount Cameron again. But of course, after I'm done with Mount Cameron, I just go back down Low Gap, not go the way I did the last time. Not because I wouldn't want to, I just don't think I'd have the time enough to do that. That's going to kind of be a we'll see thing. once I do it that day. Who knows, once I do low gaff, I may not feel like doing the extra walk even up to the Mount Cameron, because low gaff's a steep trail both ways. And if I just did low gaff all the way over to where it meets Big Creek at, that's 10 miles total there and back. If I do the tower too, that's 15 miles. Give or take, because there's a little bit of extra mileage there to get down to the campsite. Of course, that trail may be a little busier now, since that's the only trail way to get to the campsite is from Cosby. So anyone that goes to that campsite has to walk all the way over the mountain, then all the way over the mountain back. Of course, if I do it, I most likely won't record the hike up low gap. I'll probably just start it at the AT and go down the other side towards Big Creek. But I may go ahead and do the AT to the Mount Cameron again, because I'm sure there's a lot more color up there now than there was when I went. About the crossover. Of course, there'll be a few more uphills, but it shouldn't be as many. Okay, it got real windy here. All the fresh tree limbs down on the ground. Either that or there was a bear up in a tree, one of the two. That is oak tree, so they could have been up there getting nuts. Acorns. Yeah, that's probably what that was. That's probably a bear up in the tree getting acorns. Good reason for these tree branches to be on the ground. Unfortunately, I don't think we've had a good crop of acorns this year. I haven't seen as many as I've seen in the past few years. You know, a lot of times I'd have to be watching my step because it turns into a roller rink. So many of them. That on any of the trails really this year. Can't see it, but I think there's a bear up there somewhere. Sounds like something munching away. I don't know if it's you can hear it on camera or not, but it sounds like something munching real hard on some acorns. There's a bear up there somewhere munching on some acorns in the trees. I just can't see it. Trying to see it, but I can't. Kind of hard because the sun's right there too. Probably the same one that's knocking them limbs off on the trail. Just went to another tree. That's the only thing I can think of it could be. The only thing would be munching that loud on acorns. You can definitely hear them crunching. I was really hoping to do him for bald again this year too. But unfortunately, that's going to be a no-go either. Careful through here. There's actually a hole in the trail right there. It's hard to see, but it's right there. Definitely gotten breezier and breezier as I've hiked today. think I'm hearing people. Maybe wrong. I thought I heard some people yelling, talking. I'm definitely going to be surprised if I don't see anyone on this trail, and after seeing someone on the off trail. It's getting fairly late for anyone to be doing the trail. Especially for any length. Let's say it's getting near 4 right now. One minute I'm hot, next minute I'm chilly. It's beginning to look like I didn't hear anybody. Maybe just the wind blowing through the trees. Then again, they could be just going the same direction I am, and I just haven't caught up to them yet. That trail goes back down to Spruce Flat Falls Trail. I'm thinking right it comes out near where the water tower is at somewhere. I may go it one day just to do it. Not too soon though. I'm definitely hearing people now. It's just echoing through the valley though. Here in the river. Focus, it don't look there. It tried, then it didn't. hear the river down below. Means the road's down below us somewhere. I can barely see the road and the river through the trees. It's kind of right in there if you look closely. And you can see it right here. There it is. Yeah, back there when I was hearing people, I was probably hearing them from the Spruce Flat Falls Trail. Right. that is the first person I've seen on Lumber Ridge. I'm already almost back to the trailhead in Tremont. Actually, I'm surprised someone started this late. Actually above the parking lot now. They're somewhat close. You can see the parking lots down there. We're about to just where the trail goes off to Spruce Flat Falls now. We're about back where I started. Of course, I didn't video the first part of the hike because I just did it not too long ago. As you see, it's the trail that goes off the Spruce Flat Falls there. Something moving around in the woods over there. Ah, turkey. Big group of them. Not as many people here now so as when I started. I hope you enjoyed that hike there on Lumber Ridge Trail. Everyone, thanks for watching and have a great day.